Good morning and good evening and welcome to 6 p.m. Prime. I'm Pooja Shali. Delhi is the national capital. It is the cultural capital. It's the confluence of diversity of this whole nation. It's where the parliament is. And today, since morning, what we have witnessed in the capital city has been absolute mess, chaos and a national shame. The next half an hour will be our focus on Delhi. First, the headlines. Delhi Airport's Terminal 1 roof collapsed in heavy rainfall aftermath. One person lost his life, a cab driver. 8 injured rushed to the hospital. Flight operations at the Terminal 1 have been suspended. It's BJP versus the Congress blame game erupting on this. In many ways, beyond the airport premises, national capital came to a grinding halt. After a brief rainfall of a few hours, this is what the national capital city looked like. Roads, key areas, waterlogged, vehicles submerged, residents and VVIP netas stranded in this afternoon. But it's also the parliament session that's on. NEET sunset showdown escalates. No debate, sadly, only disruptions. Opposition even goes on with a claim saying Rahul Gandhi's microphone was turned off deliberately. Government says they have been ready for discussions. Opposition is ready only for disruptions.
Sir, mic to de dijiye. Two forces hain. Ek taraf
nahi mane. Okay.
Former Jharkhand Chief Minister Hemant Soren walks out of jail after 6 months. Soren has got bail after the High Court, saying there's no proof linking him to the alleged land scam case. Shocking, disturbing details coming in the POXO case slapped against former Karnataka Chief Minister B.S. Yediyurappa. According to the charge sheet, CID has detailed that Yediyurappa allegedly groped a minor girl in a locked room. And when there was outrage and uproar, money was paid to silence the victim and her mother. Yediyurappa has denied all the charges. And finally, apart from domestic politics, it's the big U.S. presidential debate that's become talk of the town. Global reactions coming in. Former and current presidents face off. While on issues like immigration, inflation and international crisis, but jibes personal and scathing at each other. Early this morning, there was a downpour for a few hours and by 5:30 a.m. at the Indira Gandhi International Airport of Delhi, at the Terminal 1, a part of the roof of ceiling with the heavy pillars and boulders collapsed. And collapsed on unsuspecting passengers and drivers. As a result, one person, a cab driver, lost his life because he got no time to even escape. 8 have received injuries. They are currently undergoing treatment at a Delhi hospital. Civil Aviation Minister was on the site. He has ensured and promised that there's going to be an investigation on this. But there's been a lot of outrage and uproar. What about the checks, the maintenance, and who will be answerable to the family of that man who lost his life? Here's a special report of what unfolded. This is the biggest story presently from the country.
Don't take your eyes off the screen. This is the Delhi International Airport. Billed as one of the world's best. Early morning on Monday, the roof at Terminal 1 came crashing down, crushing an unsuspecting cab driver to instant death. 8 others are battling injuries. It was absolute mayhem at the airport as it failed to cope with a few hours of rain.
This debris that you see behind me is the proof of as to what happened at that point in time. Unfortunately, one person has died because of this accident. 4 are injured. That's what we are being told. And right now, safety audit of Terminal 1 of the IGI airport is being done. The authorities have shut down the operation of the Terminal 1 airport. It has been completely evacuated in a way, you can say. And only tomorrow morning, when the safety audit will be done again, only after that, the operations could continue here.
Flight 2 and from Terminal 1 were cancelled. The Union Civil Aviation Minister, who recently took the charge, visited the airport to inspect the deadly collapse.
We have asked the DIAL, Delhi International Airport Limited also, is to do a verification inspection from their side. But we are not just leaving it up to themselves. The ministry, from the ministry, we have DGCA also, which underlooks the safety aspect. So they will also be supervisioning this inspection, and they will also give us a report. And from our ministry side, I can assure you that this is taken as a very serious incident.
An investigation has been ordered. The government has announced 20 lakh rupees for the family of the deceased. The opposition trained guns on the Narendra Modi government over the accident.
आज दिल्ली का एयरपोर्ट का गिरना, पानी रोड पे और घरों का अंदर आना और संविधान सदन पार्लियामेंट का अंदर कंप्लीटली बंद हो गया इलेक्ट्रिसिटी और ये सारे चीज हो रही है क्यूमिन से करप्ट एटीट्यूड का ऊपर और क्रिमिनल नेग्लिजेंस है.
The BJP hit back, saying the roof that collapsed was built in 2009 during the UPA rule. Praful Patel, the civil aviation minister in 2009, who is now in the NDA, urged political parties not to politicize the accident.
एक इमारत 15 साल पहले बनी, 15 साल तक अपना काम मतलब वहाँ से जारी था. अगर दुर्घटना हुई है तो उसकी जांच होनी चाहिए. अगर कोई गलत कुछ पाया जाएगा तो उसको दुरुस्त करना चाहिए. कोई जिम्मेदार अगर होगा तो उसके ऊपर एक्शन लेनी चाहिए. लेकिन इसमें राजनीति कहां से आती है?
While the netas bicker over the collapsed roof at the Delhi airport, the accident has exposed the authorities at multiple levels. Don't take your eyes off the screen, because what you see is living proof of criminal negligence that cost a human life. And all it took was a few hours of rain. With Amit Bharadwaj in Delhi, Bureau Report, India Today.
And this wasn't just the airport. To even reach the airport was another story. This is national capital Delhi, where a few hours of incessant rainfall, even though heavy rainfall. But what happened were roads got flooded. Streets got waterlogged. Look at this. Multiple locations from national capital Delhi throughout this morning and afternoon. Several low-lying areas. And not just of the common citizens who usually have to suffer and brace this inconvenience. This time, even the VVIPs witnessed and faced what the common citizen of this city has to face through. Delhi Minister of PWD and Water Minister Atishi's house in the Lutton zone was flooded. So was Congress MP Shashi Tharoor and other leaders as well. The question then is it just simply about the rainfall or the negligence, the callousness, the infrastructure development without a thought, the drainage system that was not kept clean with the arrival of monsoons? Here's a report on what Delhi looked like this morning.
Delhi's iconic Minto Bridge, named after a British Viceroy of India. This railway bridge near Connaught Place may be as old as the capital itself. And for those who have grown up here, this is how the Minto Bridge has looked after rains, year on year, decade after decade. From the old to the new, this is the swanky Ames flyover. But where is the flyover? It's now turned into a lake. Not too far away, in plush South Delhi, the Moolchand flyover was also waterlogged. In East Delhi's Shahadra too, vehicles were submerged. If the roads were drowning, so were the citizens, both in rainwater and in absolute civic apathy. Some were brave enough to wade through water themselves, others lucky enough to be rescued by disaster management teams. But the rains were a great leveler, with even VVIP netas and their homes flooded. This public servant, SP MP Ram Gopal Yadav, had to call for the services of the public to make his way to his car.
हमारे तो उसमें जितनी कोठियां हैं, नायक साहब रहते हैं, मंत्री जी वहां से लेके, खुद गृह राज्य मंत्री जो एनडीएमसी के मालिक हैं वो भी वहीं रहते हैं, जनरल्स रहते हैं और लोग रह रहे हैं, तो सब में पानी हमारे में सबसे ज्यादा है, हर बार होता है, वो सब घर में घुस गया पानी, नुकसान बहुत हो गया।
दिस वॉज अनदर पार्लियामेंटेरियन, कांग्रेस मनीष तिवारी वॉकिंग आउट ऑफ हिज होम इन लाटियंस दिल्ली। शशि थरूर टू वॉज स्ट्रैंडेड दो नॉट फॉर लॉन्ग, ही कैप्चर्ड दीज इमेजेस ऑन हिज फोन while making his way to the parliament.
The situation is so bad that even in the Lutyens zone where the MPs and the cabinet minister live, several of these lanes such as Raisina Road and Firoz Shah Road were inundated and these lawmakers who are going to the parliament had to the cars had to wade through these waterlogged streets, walk literally in knee deep water. Now the question is from the authorities who are responsible for managing the national capital, be it Delhi government's PWD department, the MCD or the NDMC, which largely falls under the central government, whether the desilting work was done properly.
Delhi Minister Atishi, who was on a hunger strike demanding more water for the capital till a couple of days ago, got what she wanted. Water, water and more water everywhere around her residence.
जो हमारे कई ड्रेन्स हैं, चाहे एमसीडी के हों, चाहे इरिगेशन फ्लड कंट्रोल डिपार्टमेंट के हों, पानी का फ्लो ज़्यादा होने की वजह से कई घंटे ड्रेन्स का भी ओवरफ्लो रहा। एक बार बारिश सबसाइड हुई, जब ड्रेन्स में पानी सेटल हुआ, उसके बाद दिल्ली के अलग अलग हिस्सों से पानी ड्रेन आउट होना शुरू हुआ।
1936 में 235 mm जून के महीने में बारिश हुआ था, आज सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट बारिश हुआ है 228 mm 1936 के बाद जून के महीने में। तो आप सोच सकते हैं कि जो इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर होता है वो डिजाइन नहीं होता है इतनी ज्यादा बारिश को हैंडल करने के लिए।
ये दृश्य पहली बार का नहीं है, जो भी आज तक के दर्शकों को बताऊं, ये हर साल ऐसा होता है, लेकिन आम आदमी पार्टी की सरकार गायब है, आम आदमी पार्टी के नेता गायब है, ऐसे निकम्मे लोग जो हर साल आने वाली समस्या को उसका भी कोई निदान नहीं निकाल पाते हैं, ऐसे लोगों को अपने पद पे बने रहने का क्या अधिकार है? दिल्ली की अब बताइए कितनी तकलीफ होगी, कितनी बीमारियां होंगी।
As netas continued to pass the buck, the capital crumbled. There were craters, cave-ins and wall collapses.
I'll show you in the visuals. According to locals, three people are fair trapped here at a construction site in Vasantpyar. Last night, after the heavy rains, it was seen that the water logged here, which resulted into the collapse of a wall. And according to locals and people from civic agencies, three laborers are fair trapped here. And NDRF, fire department and Delhi police is on the ground to rescue those fair trapped laborers.
This is just the arrival of monsoon in Delhi. But what will happen in the coming days? One shudders to think. Bureau Report, India Today.
The rainfall this morning in Delhi NCR was the second maximum rainfall amount ever for the month of June in Delhi. This is a big news because the Met Department has stated with the record that has emerged that today's rainfall is the second highest ever recorded in history after 1936. 24th June 1936 was when there was the highest rainfall that was reported, and then on 30th June 1981, it was about 191 millimeter that was recorded. So today, in about 43 years, we are told that the highest rainfall that was recorded by the Met Department. Abhishek Anand is joining me for the latest on this. Abhishek, this is significant as well. Of course, this is not in any way can be excused with regard to the damage we have seen. That is also a policy infrastructure issue. But even then, 3 hours of morning rainfall, second highest since 1936.
Well, certainly, Pooja, this kind of rainfall puts a lot of pressure on the already crumbling drainage system of a metropolitan city like Delhi. Of course, the municipal authorities are to be blamed because of the poor desilting of the drains. Also, there is a peculiar problem in the national capital due to a large number of unauthorized colonies. There are no storm drains, particularly in the areas of northwest, northeast, and east Delhi. But when we see waterlogging submerged underpasses in the Lutyens, in New Delhi area, so this is something else. This we cannot compare to the unauthorized areas in the outer Delhi, in the northwest Delhi. This is completely a failure of desilting of drains, of pre-planning of monsoon. Of course, there was more rain, but Pooja, the timing in which the rain was actually happening was not a traffic time. It was the wee hours. It was like from 2:30 a.m. to 5:30 a.m. It's like no traffic on the roads. So there was plenty of time for the agencies to act actually and take the water out using pumping sets from the roads and the underpasses.
Stay on with
but
me.
It didn't
yes.
happen. And you will see.
We are told that 228 milliliter in Delhi was the rainfall that's been recorded between 2:30 a.m. to 5:30 a.m. That has been observed. This is the Safdarjung Observatory by the Met Department. This is being seen as the second highest after 1936. But, like he's also pointing out, Abhishek is correct to say that there is a high rainfall that's expected because of the monsoon season. And therefore, why shouldn't, with this expectation and checks, desilting, cleanage of drains and other united platform for all agencies to come together to resolve and ensure what we saw today in and around Delhi should not have happened. Abhishek, so this is the big news that we are coming in because it's monsoon season. Delhi has faced it. It was expected. What do you think is the issue? Do you think it's also about how, like you and I have often seen in Delhi, quick to shift the blame? Aam Aadmi Party will say BJP, LG, centre is not approving. Centre, BJP, MCD will earlier used to say Aam Aadmi Party, elected government is not cooperating. Do you think this layered structure of Delhi is becoming a problem as well?
Well, certainly, Pooja, if there is one agency to do the job, if there is one agency to, put the blame on, there is not one single agency. There is multiplicity of agencies, and this is the problem, that this agency comes under the central government and that agency comes under the Delhi government. So this is how the blame game has started. The desilting starts way back in the summer seasons, and the silt which comes out from the drain shall be disposed of properly. But we have seen that the silt, all the cleaning, all the garbage which has been pulled out from the drains were actually put there right beside the drains. And after a spell of or two spells of rain, the silt again went back into the drains. So this is how it's happening in the national capital since last many years. The population in Delhi is ever rising. It's not going to stop. What is going to stop is the multiplicity, and that is the only way out of this. So this 2.5 hours of rain,
Abhishek, would sit
hours.
Together for a change, irrespective of ideologies and politics, and think of the person on the ground. Perhaps leaders who have faced inconvenience today may want to think on it. Thank you very much, Abhishek, for the latest on that. For the viewer watching this, wondering why is there so much political blame game? Why can't they have one department, one agency decided? Here's why. There's a multi-layered administration in Delhi. As a national capital, it's not a state, it's a union territory. It is where, in many ways, seen as the power center as well. Look closely. There is a Municipal Corporation of Delhi, which is currently led by the Aam Aadmi Party. So, for example, their responsibility is to clean the roads. If the road, example, the road in your colonies, in your localities, is less than 60 feet wide, that is the responsibility of the MCD. Then comes in the Public Works Department, PWD. This is a part of the Delhi government, again led by the Aam Aadmi Party this time. Their responsibility are the bigger roads, for example, Ring Road, Outer Ring Road. Then comes in the NDMC, New Delhi Municipal Corporation. That is controlled by the government at the centre, which is currently the Bharatiya Janata Party. And the NDMC areas are where the VVIPs, Lodhi Estate, all of these members of parliament who faced inconvenience was in the NDMC zone. So this is how it happens. And of course, in many ways, then there's a bureaucracy, then there's the lieutenant governor. And that is why, rather than sit together and unite, our netas are constantly ready to shift accountability and responsibility and have a blame game. Anmol Bali is joining me for the latest on that. And, you know, it's very disappointing. I've been a Delhi resident all my life, and you would think that these netas would come together. But over the years, Anmol, all we have seen is वो उनका एरिया है, वो उनका ज्यूरिसडिक्शन है, ये इनका ब्यूरोक्रेसी का प्रॉब्लम है, एलजी ने फाइल नहीं अप्रूव किया है, एंड वी हैव पीपल हु हैव टू वेड थ्रू द नेक डीप वाटर. व्हाट इज द करंट सिचुएशन ऑफ द पॉलिटिकल शोडाउन ओवर दिस?
पूजा, लास्ट नाइट इट वाज सीन दैट आफ्टर द हैवी डाउनपोर नेशनल कैपिटल विटनेस्ड हैवी रेन व्हिच हैज ब्रॉट काइंड ऑफ स्टैंड स्टिल लाइक सिचुएशन इन द मॉर्निंग. इट वाज सीन लॉन्ग ट्रैफिक जैम, वाटर लॉगिंग, roads and streets inundated, and not only in the North Delhi, in the South Delhi, but even the Central Delhi under the NDMC, which is also called the Lutyen Zone, witnessed streets and road inundated. Things were floating on the water, cars and motorbikes and carts were submerged into the water. There were scary visuals coming from all over the national capital. And after all of this, it was seen that political blame game has started. Now the Aam Aadmi Party is blaming on the Bharatiya Janata Party. BJP is blaming on the Delhi government, on the AAP government. And on the other hand, they blame on the LG house. But even the big question remains is that even the Lutyen Zone, which is also called the power center of the India, was submerged into the water. The visuals were coming that Ram Gopal Yadav, Samajwadi Party MP, who was coming out from his home to go towards the parliament for the session, was seen being lifted by his helpers. He was helped and was
keep tracking, keep getting us more visuals on what's unfolding in Delhi. People continue to suffer, and the horrific incident at the Delhi airport as well. Look how people have to wade through. These are busy intersections. Today, people had to hold each other to survive and cross the submerged waters. We have some big breaking news coming in. Let's take a look at that. The big story, of course, has been Delhi's Indira Gandhi International Airport Terminal 1 incident. According to information received from Delhi police, a case has been registered against unknown person under sections of 304A, 337 in Delhi's, this is the domestic airport terminal. There is a domestic airport police station also in that jurisdiction where this case has been filed. FIR has been registered on the statement of the Delhi Police Sub-Inspector. 304A is important because this is death by negligence, and that is where accountability and responsibility will have to be placed. Then there is 337, that is endangering the life and personal safety of another. Remember, it's not just about that cab driver or other passengers. This could have been any of us heading to the airport to catch a flight. Deceased has been identified as a 45-year-old Ramesh Kumar, resident of Rohini, Delhi. Himanshu Mishra is joining me for the latest on that. Himanshu, ye jo charges add kiye gaye hain is complaint pe aur jisko FIR banaya gaya hai, iske hisab se to ek accountability, responsibility bhi honi chahiye, kyunki injured hai, death ho gayi hai. और ये तो कोई भी हो सकता था.
बिल्कुल, जिस तरीके से ये हादसा हुआ और जिस वक्त ये हादसा हुआ, वहां कोई भी हो सकता था, और लोग थे, सभी 8 लोग वहां पर घायल हुए हैं. क्योंकि जो वो पूरा स्ट्रेच था, वो आप समझिए तकरीबन 50 मीटर का वो स्ट्रेच था, और 3 गेट उस पूरे स्ट्रेच में आते हैं. लेकिन गनीमत बस ये थी कि जिस वक्त ये हादसा हुआ, उस वक्त लोग वहां पर नहीं थे. वहां पर दिन के वक्त में अगर ये हादसा होता तो दिन के वक्त में लोग होते हैं वहां पे. लेकिन अब पुलिस ने इस पूरे मामले में जो FIR दर्ज की है, उसमें जो धारा लगाई है, सबसे पहले उन्होंने 304A, क्योंकि रमेश एक शख्स की मौत हुई है, इसलिए लापरवाही से हुई मौत की धारा यहां पर जोड़ी गई है. इसके अलावा 337 जो ग्रीवियस इंजरीज हुई है, जो और लोग थे जो घायल हुए हैं, उनकी वजह से लगाई गई है. लेकिन ये दोनों धाराएं पूजा यहां पर अवेलेबल है. लेकिन इंपॉर्टेंट यहां पर क्या होगा कि जो पूरा इन्वेस्टिगेशन होगा, जो ये FIR दर्ज की गई है, तो अकाउंटेबिलिटी फिक्स होगी. देखना ये होगा कि जब पुलिस इस पूरे मामले की जांच करती है तो किसकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी फिक्स की जाती है, किसकी गलती देखी जाती है. क्योंकि क्या वहां पर पूरी तरीके से मेंटेनेंस की नहीं थी, उन चीजों पर ध्यान दिया गया कि नहीं दिया गया, पिछले काफी समय से उस पर उसको मेंटेन किया गया था कि नहीं किया गया था. क्योंकि अंदर जब वो जो लोहे के पूरे पिलर हैं जो नीचे गिरे थे, उनमें अंदर ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे काफी हद तक जंग भी लग चुका था. तो क्या कोई ऐसा शख्स था, कोई ऐसी कंपनी थी जिसको इसको मेंटेनेंस का काम दिया गया है? तो ये बहुत सारी इंपॉर्टेंट चीज होगी,
बहुत जरूरी होगा हिमांशु, क्योंकि ये दिल्ली का एक कॉस्मोपॉलिटन सिटी का प्रोजेक्शन था ऑफ अ वर्ल्ड क्लास एयरपोर्ट. एंड द मैनर इन विच वन रेनफॉल हैज लेड टू द कोलैप्स ऑफ अ सीलिंग रेजेस मेनी क्वेश्चंस, एंड वी विल बी ट्रैकिंग दैट बिग स्टोरी. But one of the biggest defining images for this rain mess in Delhi has been for years now is the Minto Bridge, sadly. There seems to be no resolution to it. Vehicles get submerged like an annual event. Look at this. So we decided to bring forth earlier images, even when there were black and white images available. We brought it out from the archives till 2024. Look at that. Minto Bridge. The Minto Bridge hasn't changed and the chaos around it hasn't changed at all. Same story, same scenario. Why is it that in a modern Delhi, modern India, this chaos, this specific inundated road is always seen? Why can't the drainage system be repaired? And this, remember, is the most important arterial road. It connects Delhi's railway station, Connaught Place, towards airport, toward ITO. And therefore, a lot of people have to take, specifically when they head to important destinations. Nothing seems to change on ground. Political bickering, of course, only gets heightened. On that note, I want to wrap up this bulletin. Thank you very much for watching. Stay tuned and we'll continue to update. Hopefully, the authorities today will wake up and ensure this does not get repeated again.